Dear people of God, we thank God who brings us together today to praise Him through the institution of the family He created at the very beginning of humanity, and which He exemplifies in the Holy Family of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. Family life should be a school in which human life is schooled in the heart and the life in God. This institution, as we know, is a creation of God, and in it human beings are influenced for their betterment. In this family unit, people are placed in an environment where they can grow in godliness. And in order to facilitate this process of growth and to preserve godliness in humanity, the Book of Sirach has given us very good teachings, especially for those members of the family called the children. Children are specifically addressed by Sirach in the first reading. And I think I shall take a bit of time trying to help us understand the mind of Sirach. He has many other practical lessons for people, like dealing with friends, dealing with guests, handling matters of money, and dealing with leaders and servants. There are many, many lessons in Sirach. And actually, it's a practical book for Christian living. So I urge the youth to read this book of Sirach, which is also called Ecclesiasticus, and see the lessons for life that are meant to mold us in the heart and a life of God. So Sirach is inviting the children, even in these changing circumstances, to embrace virtue as it is put across to them by their parents. The children are expected to give honor to their parents. This is what Sirach has opened with in the first reading. To give honor to God might not mean bowing before your parents, which is also good. It goes beyond that. Giving honor to parents requires of the children to live upright lives before all people, beginning from the family. Giving honor to parents requires the children to keep a good name for their family. And also giving honor to parents requires of children to be honest with their parents and other people. And so Sirach is inviting all children, even today, to consider living honorably. And you have to know that the honor you give eventually returns to you. And in this line, again, Sirach is calling upon children to help their parents when they are in need. In need is also white. By face value, it's good to help a parent when she's doing dishes. You can help a parent to wash his or her car at home. You can do the clothes and iron them for your parents and cleaning the house. Those are good things to do because they train you to be practical in doing things for others, even for yourself. in the need also goes beyond that, as I have said. Parents need to be assisted when they are in need of your patience. They need your patience and gentility, and not treat them as these gadgets that are treated with finger touches. Parents are in need of your patience, and not treat them like finger touch gadgets. Parents are in need of your ears as they try to point out to you the way you should go. Parents are in need of your eyes to see the way they are marking out for you, especially as they build the legacy of the family. Parents all need your quiet as they plan your future. So when parents are in need, go deeper in this aspect. And these are the things they need from you: your ear, your patience, your eyes, and even your mouth, to engage in truthful dialogue with them, never telling them a lie. And Sirach is also inviting children to be supportive to their parents, especially when they enter into senior age. They become frail, and many times they are worn out because of us. They are worn out because of accompanying us. So they need their comfort from you. It's a way of returning good for the good they have done to you. So being supportive in a creative way, helping them in their plans, in the little ways they are still doing, is a good thing to do and an honorable thing to consider. So you can still be supportive to your parents in those ways as they become senior in years. And their being senior in years is also a benefit for you, because their experience can become the foundation of your life that will lead you into a greater future of life. These parents need to be treasured, to be taken importantly, and see their worth because of what they did for you, the sacrifices they made for you, and the wishes that they have for you to have a good future. Parents are in turn also asked to prevent any abuses within the family, no disrespect of family members, no wastage of resources, and no disruption of family peace, and never to be oppressive. This is what St. Paul does tell us in the second reading. So, dear children, today is a day for you to take some time and sit along with your parents and try to enter into their world and ask them, that mom and dad, how have you done this to bring me up to 17 years, 16 years? How has it been possible? They will tell their story and tell you those great moments of life that have made you who you are. So in this way, they are schooling you into the heart and life of God, which will make you more godly and useful the world. Therefore, we pray for our families to live in loving understanding, in enduring patience, in promoting communal growth and improvement, to provide all-round formation, to be untiring in listening, to to give constructive correction and be godly in considering every aspect of life as they journey with us through life. If we think this is impossible, let's look at the gospel. Saint Joseph, in his humility, led the family of God. And in him, we see important aspects that help to build and strengthen a family to be what it is. In Joseph, we see, and Mary as well, protection. They gave protection to the child who was entrusted to them. This child was so precious, and when Herod wanted to kill him, when Herod became a threat to his life, they fled to Egypt. Herod can represent every threat against life. And we know many threats today that are threatening the lives of children. Let's keep these children away from these dangers. Let's flee Herod and go to Egypt where we shall be safe. And Herod is still alive. Herod is in abortion. Herod is in child sex abuse. And Herod is in many, many forms of abuses that children suffer today. So you are encouraged to flee to Egypt, the place of safety, where these people, the little ones, can survive and thrive in a more peaceful environment. Parents Joseph and Mary were providers. Joseph worked with his hand as a carpenter to provide for his family. And in this way, Jesus learned carpentry, and by learning carpentry, he consecrated human work. In Joseph, we see a good steward and responsible manager. In time of crisis, when the angel came to him and told him to go to Egypt, he promptly acted. There was no procrastination, no postponement, because danger does not compromise. This is the way parents should act when the family is in danger. In Joseph, we also see a spirit of sacrifice. He had to go an extra mile to go to Egypt. He walked on foot, walked through hardships because of the good of the family that was under his care. In him and Mary, we see obedience. They promptly acted on the message of the angel. Obedience should be taught in the family to help us be dependable, reliable, and trustable stewards, especially as we relate with God and society. They never betrayed the trust God gave them because of obedience. There is cooperation. They all worked together as a team in order to work for the safety of the child and took him where he was most safe. Generous solidarity in a crisis, without resentment, with no indignation and resistance, is a good way of building cooperation in the family. Also, there was unconditional trust. Trust that God is in charge of everything. Let's allow God to take care of our families, and everything will be well with us, as we see in the life of Joseph and Mary. And there was good communication. Joseph communicated with the angel, and he did exactly what the angel required of him, because he knew it was from God. A heart and ear that listens accurately to the message of God acts with commitment and dedication, and the outcomes are great. Our families need to learn that. And St. Paul has told us in the second reading that let us perfect perfect those distinguishing marks of love, which are compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, patience, forbearance, and forgiveness. These are the marks that distinguish a family, that will help a family grow in godliness and make a family useful to society, and so exemplify the life in God that people most need today. May God help us all, and may the Lord be with you.